Shopping for a hatchback in India today is usually difficult business, a bit like navigating through the Matrix or understanding exactly what was running through Christopher Nolan's mind when he made Inception. It's that confusing. But at the very top, especially in the realm of diesels, there aren't too many choices available. We showed you two of the best options a couple of weeks ago on the show, the i20 diesel and the Polo diesel. But now, Fiat has another alternative. This is the Punto 90 bhp, and Fiat's calling this the most powerful diesel hatch you can buy in India today.
Believe it or not, this is the 10th variant of the Punto that's available in India. And like the others, it's drop-dead gorgeous. Not good-looking like the Polo or funky like the i20. No, this car is beautiful, though the dull grey of our test car doesn't really do it justice. The 90 bhp distinguishes itself from its siblings thanks to the discreet badge on the boot and will only be available in the Emotion variant with the larger 15-inch alloy rims. Inside, the sporty touch is courtesy the red stitching on the black and grey seats, and the Blue & Me USB Bluetooth system also comes as standard.
But obviously, what sets this Punto apart from the others is under the bonnet. Fiat's 1.3-litre multi-jet diesel engine now gets a variable geometry turbo that boosts power output from 76 to 93 PS. That's 3 brake horsepower more than the i20. How does that affect the driving experience? Let's find out.
Because of its weight, the Punto has always felt more sluggish than its competition. But the extra horses and torque really has made a difference to this car. Turbo lag is still evident below 1600 RPM, but the power delivery is more linear. But what lets the engine down and turns out to be a big irritant in city traffic is the gearing. Let me show you.
So now let's say we're at a traffic signal and you take off in first and she shoots out of the blocks like Usain Bolt. Short shift to second to counter that, and suddenly there's no power. You got to wait then an eternity until the engine spools up to 2,500 RPM, and then she's off again like Ben Johnson on steroids.
The 90 bhp may be the most powerful diesel hatch in India, but it's still not the fastest. The 0 to 100 sprint is dispatched in 15.75 seconds, almost 3 seconds quicker than the 76 PS Punto, but still not a patch on the class-leading Hyundai i20 CRDI's time of 13.01 seconds.
Another familiar Fiat problem is this gear shift, which is extremely imprecise and notchy. Especially when shifting from second to third, sometimes it takes a moment to find the right gear. And the lever, well, it just feels fragile and kind of light, unlike the solid, communicative and extremely meaty steering wheel.
What has improved, and noticeably so, is the fuel economy. The extra horses gives the Punto a better power-to-weight ratio, and the result is 15.5 km per litre in the city and an astonishing 19.18 km per litre on the highway. The ride quality too is excellent, with all manner of potholes and ruts dispatched with minimal fuss.
And when you turn off the highways and onto some twisty mountain roads, well, the Punto really comes alive. It's always been a great handler, but now the wider tires and a lot more poke has made it even more fun. It really gives you the confidence to push hard and explore your limits as a driver.
This new variant of the Punto costs just over 7 lakhs ex-showroom Mumbai, similar to the Polo, and around 30,000 rupees less than the i20, which is good value. The extra power has done good things to the car, making it more drivable and efficient. Okay, it's still no performance king, but this is the car the diesel Punto should have always been and is certainly the best variant of the Punto you can buy in India today.
The Punto's been around for a year now, and even though it's so damn good looking, the thing that's prevented us from giving it a total thumbs up has been the iffy build quality. And sadly, that doesn't seem to have been addressed. Even this 90 bhp produced some annoying squeaks and rattles. And that's a pity, because this car has a lot going for it. Power, performance and price. Now if they'd only do something about that build quality,